8.1, page 74. P Corp acquired 80% of ordinary share on this date. And our year end is 31st December. On 31st December 04, last year's closing, S Corp's account show revaluation surplus of 4 and retained earning of 15. This is your opening. Last year's closing is this year's opening. The fair value of NCI is 7. So given is year end 31st December 25, prepare SFP for this company. So we need to calculate the goodwill. What's the consideration transfer? 50 plus, we own how many percent? 80%. So we have to plus the NCI, 7. So 50 plus 7. Yes. And less the net asset acquired, it will be 10. And retained earning, how much? 15. Retained earning is 15. What about now? Now it's 39. So we need April. You look at the plan here. You should assume that profit accrue evenly over the year. Means the increase here 24. It's even over the year. Means you divide by 12, means every month 2. So it will be 3 months here and 9 months here. You can plus or you can minus from here. 18. 3 times 2, 6, 21. Yeah, you minus 18. Okay. Reserves opening is 4, closing also 4. Means there's no increase during the year. Means at the date when I acquire is also 4. Therefore, 10 plus the revaluation. This one will be the booking. You put it lah. 15 plus. Two times three, yeah. 21. Okay. Goodwill done. Retained earning. So I need to know the post acquisition means this one here. Post acquisition will be from here to here. After acquire until today, so we take 39 now minus pre-act. This is pre, therefore it is 18, or you can take 9 times 2 also. Can post acquisition profit. So 40 and 39 minus pre-act. This is post acquisition, so we share 80%. And also, not here, sorry. NCI, 20%. Next page. Where do you get this? 7 from working one. This will be the fair value of NCI from working one. 7, yeah. Then what about the revaluation? Same concept as retained earning. Revaluation, parent plus subsidy post act 18. Revaluation parent 7. What about subsidy? Subsidy now is 4. When I pre act also 4. So nothing. And I times it 80% nothing. 20% NCI nothing. Same concept. That's it. So you just have to control add across. This will be the answer. Okay. Number 9. Doesn't have to settle. Number 9. The form of consideration transferred. Okay. Goodwill calculation. Consideration transferred or consideration paid transferred. So far we know it's cash. I paid 20 million to buy 80%. Our consideration transfer can be by way of share exchange. We issue our share to buy their share, company share, because our share work, we do have a value. So rather than us paying cash, we use our own share to buy their company. Okay. And this is a very common practice. Okay. Share exchange. It can be deferred consideration. Deferred consideration. It can be contingent. Consideration. It can be by way of a 10% loan note. So I can acquire a subsidy using one of these means, one of these methods. Pay cash, issue my share, I can defer the consideration. What's the difference between these two? Defer. Defer means I agree to pay later. I buy the share now. Okay. I pay you cash now. Share I get issued to you now, but the consideration, there's another small portion which I'm going to pay you next year or next 2 years. Means it's deferred by 1 year or 2 years. Normally the question is 1 to 2 years, okay, not or a few months. So deferred consideration, contingent consideration means we attach a condition. Okay, if the company shares increase by 10%, then I'll pay you this amount in the future, 1 year time. If your company make this much of profit, then I'll pay you another 2 million. So contingent consideration is depending on the condition. Cannot place on the purchase here. Based on share price, based on the market share, it can be based on the profit. So if you meet, then we have to pay. So this one depends. Deferred consideration confirm must pay in the future. Contingent, it depends on the condition. Okay. And 100% loan note is I'm going to take over your share. Okay, so you're the shareholder. This is your company. I want to take over your company. So I can pay you cash. I can issue you my share. Or I can issue you loan note. So this my loan note means you lend me money. So the money I use to take over your company. So now I've taken over. Every year I pay you 10% loan. And let's say this loan note is for 5 years. I'll pay you back interest, plus year 5, interest and principal. Okay? So, we have to pay back because this is a loan. It's a loan taken to buy over. Okay? Of course, I can buy for others also. I issue loan note, buy. Okay? Loan note to buy. One more. These are all add up done. This is my percentage, assuming I own 80. The method of payment will be this much. And fair value of NCI. So this is the NCI's 20%. Do you still remember there are two methods to calculate NCI? One is based on fair value. One is proportionate, the apportionment, the proportionate share. Okay. I'll show you which one. As a yeah, nah, this one, NCI. So NCI can be valued at full value or fair value. This is a very common one. Or it can be at proportionate. So full value means the goodwill belongs to the parent and also NCI. This one belongs only to the parent. A quick one, example, yeah. This is a net asset and the fair value. This is the, we call it the method one. Okay, the method one. So cost of is it here. I acquire 90% for 2 million. Then the other 10% is belongs to NCI and is valued at 300. So my 90% NCI is 300. So 90%, 2 million, 300. So this is our 10%. Less net asset acquired as per the question 1.8. So this one is 500, belongs to parent and NCI, the goodwill. Okay. Otherwise, I show you another method, right? This one rather than this. It will be like this. Consideration transfer, I pay 2 million. And NCI will be based on proportionate, not on fair value. So we have to find the net asset acquired. Normally we have equity share, means the ordinary share. We got the pre-acquisition. And the total given this one is how much? 1.8. These two add up. Consideration transfer to NCI is on proportion. Not sure, we have to find this one less than asset acquired. Equity share. Pre-act. Total given is 1.8. So this subsidiary is 1.8 here, meaning it will be because I acquire 90%, means 10% belongs to NCI. We use this proportion. 2180 minus it will be 380. This one belongs only to the parent because this is based on proportionate. Correct. So my 90% and 10%, how much I pay? 2. Huh? Okay. This is 100%. And here is 180, 2180. My portion, and this is NCI's portion. What is the net asset that we acquire? 1.8. My 90% of this is 1620. 90% of this. 10% of this, 180, belongs to NCI. 380, nothing. Can you see this goodwill all belongs to parent? If it is based on fair value, 300. Gone. Because this one old already. So a bit slower. 180. and 1620. If this is based on 300, then the goodwill will be 380 and this one 120. So 500, meaning this goodwill of 5 belongs to parent and NCI. Okay, not? So 500, because it's at fair value, goodwill belongs to both. And our exam question most of the time will be on fair value. Okay, this concept more important higher level, your SBR. Yeah. Yeah. Correct. Yes. Correct. Yeah. Just different figure lah. Yeah. Meaning if you apply to this example, earlier, of course, this one is 300, right? Our NCI will be 300. We plus the share, the 20% whatever share. Okay. But if it's at proportionate 180, same thing. It's the same. Okay. You can see in our console, let's say this NCI, our if it's proportionate, means our goodwill will be lower, correct? Our goodwill is lower. And then, of course, NCI is also lower. That's why it's balanced off. Goodwill lower, NCI also lower. When it's a fair value, means the goodwill include NCI, then by NCI also higher. So it's balanced off. Okay, now back to this one. Fair value of NCI. And what else will appear here? Now let's look at less net asset acquired, equity share, pre-act. Of course, you got share premium, everything will be there. Fair value adjustment. We may have the intangible asset. Yeah, intangible asset. Goodwill, not goodwill, this one will be the brand name or whatever you will appear here. Contingent liability. So we acquire this asset, we add up contingent liability, we minus. From there, we got our goodwill. This one I'll show you before, no? Yes, sir. Contingent liability. When we took over subsidies, contingent liability, we will learn one of the standard IAS 37. Contingent liability is a disclosure item. It's not recognized in their book as liability. But when it comes to console, okay, when we took over the subsidy, even though it's a disclosure item for contingent, we still recognize this liability for business combination. So there's a conflict here. Standard individual account, parent individual, we do not recognize, individual do not recognize the liability. It's just a disclosure. But when business combination, even the disclosure of 20,000, we will recognize the 20,000 is part of our goodwill calculation. Okay? Same thing for intangible asset. Individual, we haven't learned this two standard yet. Individually may not have to or should not recognize this intangible. But for business com, yes, we will recognize. So it's conflict with the individual standard. Then come to business call. Okay. Now, so we're going to look at share exchange, deferred, and also contingent. This one straight from the example later question, but these two we need to know. Share exchange and deferred. For deferred consideration, this is what you have to do. Year zero, I pay cash, deferred consideration, share exchange later. So now with deferred consideration, yeah, I agree to pay 1,000 cash, and I also agree to defer the consideration, agree to pay lah, 220 in year 1. First January next year, means exactly 1 year later. So I pay 1,000 and I'm going to pay 220 in 1 year time. So still have to pay. What must I do with this 220? When they tell you the discount rate is 10%, you have to discount 1 year. Okay, you learn before discounting? Yeah. How to discount the 220? Yeah, how? This 220 discount 10%. Yeah, how? Should I divide our time? Yeah, correct. Future value. We want to discount the present value. Divide. 1.1. Power by? We discount 1 year. Okay. Remember? Look ahead. Important concept. This one we have to apply in different consideration. We're going to apply in our PPE later. Financial instrument. And IS 41. All same concept, discounting. The table, the table they will give you like this. At 10%, year one, they give you in discount factor the table 0.909, 0.826, 0.751, 0.683, 0.621, 10%. Okay, now. So now that this will be year 220. So you times is 0.909. If given factor, you times. If no factor is given, then you divide by 1.1. It's the same. Okay, not? It's the same. Be careful. So you have to know whether should you divide or should you times. Divide means divide by the percentage 1.1. If they give you the factor already, then you times 0.90. And normally they give you the factor. Okay. So 220 you times with 0.909, you will get about 200. So discount, you get 200. Means the purchase consideration is cash plus deferred 200. You okay? So our goodwill calculation, how much should I put here? Yeah, you're working, you put it here, 220 divided by 1.1, you have 200 here. It's part of my goodwill calculation today. Okay, and you have to unwinding of discount. So you have to compound by one more year. Means you have discount it already, then you have to unwind back. We call this unwinding of the discount. So you unwind, because you discount 10%, you unwind 10%. 10% is 10% of the 200 is 20. So what do you do with this 20? You charge to finance cost, interest. So, yes, you at the end of the year, you're going to unwinding of the discount. Okay. So unwind means you just compound 10%, 20. So the double entry is debit finance cost, you charge to your interest. So where do I credit? Liability, correct? Deferred consideration is a liability. So we increase our liability. Deferred consideration, credit. So original in my book, I owe 200 today. When I unwind, I debit interest, I increase my liability to 220. So at this date, my liability is 220 in my book. When I'm going to pay? Tomorrow. Because I agreed to pay 1 year later. Okay, 1st January I buy, I pay 1st January next year. So I'm going to pay tomorrow. So tomorrow when I pay, I credit bank 220 and I debit this liability. Okay, so you unwind, then remember to, you discount, remember to unwind. Okay, finance cost. must pay. Okay. Working is better to show. Can. If you look at we follow past, yeah. Okay. The modern answer, they just plus or minus. So it means acceptable. Not necessary. Huh? No need. Don't open it. Yeah. Okay, nah. When this one I must accusation part way through. Okay, page 75. Form of consideration, cash, share exchange, deferred consideration. This is the one. The parent, straight now, 9.1.1. The parent acquired 80% of the subsidiary's 80 million share. It paid $5 per share and agreed to pay another 110 1 year later. So the parent's cost of capital is 10. So goodwill calculation will be how much? 80% of 80 million share means I'm purchasing 64 million share. 80% of 80 million, 64 million. And each share is worth 5. I pay 5. So every share I buy, I pay you 5. So 320 cash. On top of that, I agreed to pay 110 1 year later. So this one I have to discount by 10%. Divide by 1.1, power by 1. Then so it'll be 100. So it's part of my goodwill calculation. So this is the 80% and this one will be 20%. Okay. Then remember to unwind. Unwind will be unwinding at 10%. Then unwinding of the discount. Of 100, 10. So debit finance cost, interest, and you credit your deferred consideration. Two way to look at show you're working. You either take 100, you plus the interest, or sometimes you look at modern answer, they just take 100, you times it 1.1. Unwind 10% is the same. Done. Contingent consideration. Meaning, I agree to pay provided the certain condition that is attached to this acquisition is met, then I'll pay. Okay, now, let's make it simple, pay. It can be the other way around. If you meet certain condition or do not miss, you must pay me back. It can be two way. So we focus on one way first. All right. So I agree to pay. So contingent consideration is a liability to me. So what do I do? Example here. The parent acquired 60% of ordinary share, 100 million. And for cash payment, 120. Okay. And a further payment of 55 if the subsidiary's post-acquisition profit exceeded agreed amount. So today, we do not know whether it will exceed or not. So must we do anything today? Yes, we still have to calculate. Understand? Repeat, huh? I agree to pay 55. If another 55, if the profit exceeded the agreed figure, if I said 10 million, I'll pay 55. Example. So at the moment, at the day of acquisition today, we do not know whether they will exceed or not. So there could be a liability, may not be a liability. So must we do anything? Business combination, we must record. Okay, not? So the contingent consideration, as usual, just discount 1 year, which is 1.1, so 50. But this 50, as part of goodwill, it will be our liability also, 50. But will it be, is it payable? Not sure. But we're still going to recognize. Then you unwind. Same thing. Correct. No, yeah, it's called provision. Huh? Okay. Because we recognize, then it should be a provision. Contingency, we only disclose. Contingency, we disclose. So in this case, we recognize, so we treat as our liability. Okay, right? And liability, we will learn one standard. Liability may change. So after you unwind, probably the liability, we more or less know that we're going to meet the target or not. So sometimes the agreement is, if we hit this target, we pay 55. If we hit this target only, we pay 40. If this target, we pay 30. So we will use the best estimate. Maybe my liability now, because lower profit, my liability is only 30. So must I adjust this liability? Yes. So liability, we do remeasurement. Is it okay? If let's say, now that it's nearer that I know my liability is payable or not, I know my liability is 30. So it will be 55 minus 30 means I adjust a minus 25 to 30, right? Because I owe 30. So what do you do with this 25? Liability down, good. So income. Understand? Income, yes. Because our liability reduced. Originally, when I buy, I thought my liability is this much. But now the profit is not met, then my liability reduced by 25 to 30. The question will tell you reduced to how much, and then the balance is just to the payment. The other one is what? No, deferred, no. Deferred is confirmed as payment. Contingent, we may remeasure. For liability, we may remeasure. Okay? So our exam question so far, it will be contingent liability. Means I agree to pay cash. But it is possible that if certain condition is met, I will agree to issue additional share to you. So do I have to pay cash? No, means it's not my liability. Okay, now if you meet certain condition, I'm gonna pay issue additional share. That one is equity share. So when we have to issue equity, means I'm gonna debit. Okay, now debit to this equity, and then we credit issue share. So no liability, but it will be under equity because I'm going to pay share. So not liability, but it will be under equity. Is it okay? Repeat. So two things. If I agree to pay in the future, if we meet certain condition, I agree to pay cash, meaning I recognize as liability today. And liability, we do remeasure. Liability, we do remeasurement. But if I agree to issue share, I recognize today, in the future, no remeasurement. Okay, this one is IS, one of IS on financial instruments. We haven't touched yet. So once we touch that, this sentence will be repeat, liability, remeasurement, equity, no remeasurement. So you can see from here, when we agree to issue them share, means equity, it should not be remeasured. Means whatever that is recognized today, means 1 year later, no remeasurement. Same. Not like this one. We can remeasure from 55 become 25 or 30. It must be remeasured for liability. Okay. So deferred consideration done, contingent done, share exchange very common for your exam question. The consideration paid by the parent can take different form, cash or share in itself, or combination of both cash and share. P acquired all 40,000 equity share of S-Co by issuing 5 of our own share for every 4 shares we own, we buy. 5 for 4. 5 of our own share for every 4. The market value of our share is worth $6. The net asset, okay, they tell us the net asset here is 165. Par value is $1. So I'm acquired all 40,000 shares. If I buy 4 shares, how many shares must I issue? 5, right? If I acquire 5, 4, means I divide by 4, I times it 5, means I'm going to issue 5 of my share. If I buy, acquire 8 share, means I'm going to issue how many of my share? Divide 4 times 5. I'm going to buy, issue 10. So, in other words, you always divide all your times and you divide. Times 5, divide 4. Now I'm acquiring 40,000 share. So divide by 4 times 5, I'm going to acquire 50,000 share. I'm going to issue 50,000 share, my own share. And this shares that I'm going to issue will be at $6. Par value is $1. Okay. So double entry to record issue of share. There, here. Credit share capital always at par value. The balance, everything will go to share premium. The $5 will go to share premium. Where do I debit? I don't receive money for this. So it will increase my investment. Okay, now. So this is my investment, 300. After which, later when we console, investment will be eliminated. Correct. We recognize the investment and then goodwill calculation, eliminate. So now, I acquire all 40,000 shares issuing my own share. So investment is 30. Goodwill calculation, consideration transferred, 300. The net asset acquired, 165. So the goodwill is 135. Normally what we have is cash, share exchange. But this one don't have. So straight away 300. Fair value of NCI. Don't have. Because purchase all. And the net asset given here is 165. Okay, now this one. Expenses and issue costs. So expenses, a combination such as lawyer, accounting fee, will be written off as incurred. Expense it off. Do not adjust in our goodwill. And say, hey, I took over this company, I incurred this cost, it's a cost to me. Just like I took over the company share, I pay cash, it's a cost to me. I pay share is a cost to me. So I incur also some cost to acquire. Those expenses on issue cost here is, should not be recognized. Should not be used, included in the calculation of goodwill. Expense enough. Okay, now? Okay. Or unless here, IFRS 3, the cost of issuing share, it should be deducted from the proceed of the issue share. Example, when I issue, example here, when I issue 5,000 share of $1 each for $3, what's double entry? So one more, sorry, issue cost for issuing of the share is 600. I show the T account, debit bank, I received $5,003. 15. Credit ordinary share cap. Par value is 5. Share premium is 10. 10. Alright. And I have to pay 600. Credit 600 bank for the issue cost. The money received 5 times 3. One share I issue 3. And this is the par value. 5,000 share 5. Where should I debit? I pay issue cost. So if this is a cost incurred to issue the share, we debit to share premium. Not expenses, huh? Issue cost. You know, when we issue cost, we have to pay stamp duty, government tax. We have to get the secretary to help us to prepare all the circular. Okay, prepare many things. So you have to pay a lot of cost for that. Especially if you are a listed company, issue share, you have to have underwriters, CIMB, merchant bank, ask that, can you please help me to find buyer? Okay, not get all these things done. Receive the money. Okay, get this thing done by transferring all the shares, the ownership. So we the director, we don't know the doctor, I'm the doctor, we're the engineer, how we know what to do with this. So we get someone to help us to do it. So all those are the issue costs. Okay. Brokerage fee, commission, yeah, all these are part of the cost that we have to incur when we issue share. Okay. Yeah. Time. 7:30.